Birdman is giddy, glorious, exhilarating entertainment. It's a hugely pleasurable roller coaster ride, but it's also so layered that you need to see it again to make sense of it. For one, it begins with a man wearing only underwear levitating. In the first scene, actor Regan Thompson, played by Michael Keaton, is hovering midair. Regan was once a star. His biggest success was playing the superhero Birdman. But he is now imprisoned in that awful no man's land of a has-been. He was once famous, now he's irrelevant and tragically obscure. Regan is attempting to get traction and credibility via theatre by directing and starring in a Broadway play. But he's racked by insecurity, vanity, depression. Personally and professionally, he's a mess. It doesn't help that at regular intervals, Birdman appears. First as a voice and eventually as a person. To urge Regan to dump this foolish artistic enterprise and simply go back to being what he was, a superhero in Lycra who made millions.
Listen to me. I'm just you are the original man. Let's make a comeback.
Is Regan undergoing a midlife meltdown? Does he actually have superpowers? What exactly is going on? Director Alejandro González Iñárritu doesn't tell us. Instead, he dazzles us with a film that is funny and sad, scary and sparkling. Not to mention that the entire film appears to be done in one long take. Iñárritu and the genius cameraman Emmanuel Lubezki, who also shot Gravity, seamlessly suture scenes. The camera rushes down hallways, New York streets, apartments and theater dressing rooms. It creates a sense of breathlessness. I went crazy trying to figure out exactly where the cuts are. The script is brilliant. Witty lines are lobbed around like tennis balls. Edward Norton plays Mike Shiner, a painfully exacting Broadway theater actor. At one point, he pompously declares,
"Popularity is the slutty little cousin of prestige, my friend."
There's also a vampire-like theater critic who slams Hollywood, describing the industry as a bunch of vain and empty people giving each other awards for cartoons and pornography. All of which positions Birdman as an incredible hall of mirrors. In life, Norton is supposedly a painful method actor. Keaton was once Batman. Like Regan, he walked away from that gig, turning down a $15 million paycheck. And the biggest joke, as we speak, Birdman is walking away with the top honors at all the Hollywood awards ceremonies, where vain and empty people are giving each other awards. Iñárritu's cinema is usually so depressingly gut-wrenching that after watching one of his films, I usually need a happy Bollywood pick-me-up. But Birdman gave me an adrenaline rush. I'm going with 4.5 stars and recommending that you rush to a theater now. Film Companion is my attempt to be your film buddy. Let me know what you like and what you don't like, and keep subscribing for your film fix.